You know when you rewatch a movie you've definitely seen before, yet get so swept up in it you just feel the need to talk about it? I recently rewatched Edward Scissorhands, a movie that I used to watch all the time when I was younger and I've always remembered loving it. I hadn't seen the film in a few years and just randomly decided to watch it again, thinking, hey, this'll be fun. And within the first 15 minutes of rewatching it, the magic of this movie swept me all over again. Edward Scissorhands, to me at least, is one of those movies that feels almost undefinable. And I mean that in the best way. In the wrong hands, there's no doubt it would have been incredibly silly and an absolute mess. Instead, it's a strange gothic film that quite simply feels magical, warm and accepting of its strangeness by stepping into a world created by Tim Burton at his most personal. It definitely has his stamp of approval, and the supporting cast Burton chose fit their roles so well. Diane Wiest is Peg Boggs, the woman who takes Edward from his world into hers. She's truly a joy to watch with her optimistic viewpoints, and has a specific scene with Edward that practically invented ASMR. The legendary Vincent Price, simply known as the Inventor. Alan Arkin as the cynical, laid-back dad character. Kathy Baker as the seductive and desperate housewife Joyce. Dick Anthony Williams as Officer Allen. Olan Jones as the highly religious Esmeralda. And Anthony Michael Hall as the douchebag-turned-villainous Jim. It's essentially a fairy tale, exhibiting the best and most despicable characters involved with those stories. Burton has stated multiple times how he considers Edward Scissorhands his most personal film, and it's easy to see why. He definitely sees himself in the eyes of Edward in what is the simple story of a man wanting to be accepted. Edward truly is, without a doubt, one of the sweetest and most innocent characters of all time. Almost the entirety of the film rests on his shoulders, and Johnny Depp was able to pull off this gentle, almost puppy dog-like persona. He has more emotion and care than almost any other character in the movie. That sense of childlike wonderment when he enters the Boggs' house for the first time is so warm and touching. There's a great little moment where he goes to try on new clothes and looks into a mirror. I think this is the first time he's ever seen a reflection of himself. To prepare for the role, Johnny Depp watched many silent films to portray a character who barely says anything and has to emote through his facial expressions. And when he does speak, his soft and gentle voice just makes him even more innocent, as if he wasn't innocent enough to begin with.
I'm sorry.
It's no secret how gorgeous this movie is to look at, with its glowing, radiant colors. For starters, I think the idea of setting the movie in suburbia was the perfect choice. Every house looks the same, and the people who live there all act the same. What's interesting is how the colorfulness of the neighborhood and Edward's black skin-tight outfit really are a stark contrast to their personalities. Since it's seen through Edward's perspective, everything around him is bright and colorful, as opposed to the dull-colored mansion he's occupied all these years. The people living in the neighborhood wear bright clothing, which can give the presence of a community trying to welcome someone new. Beneath everyone's warm appearances lies an undercurrent of deceit, hatred, and bigotry.
Listen, don't you ever let anybody tell you you have a handicap.
Have you caught him yet?
Who?
Him, that cripple.
Edward Scissorhands is a strange movie, there's no denying that. It has many of the character quirks and visual eccentricities director Tim Burton has been known for concocting, but I think the most engaging and resonant aspect to this film is finding the beauty in all of that eccentricity. The scenes that really stand out that I'd like to mention for this video are the three scenes featuring the inventor and Edward. They're all flashbacks made at pivotal moments of the film. The first one occurs right before Edward is properly introduced to the whole neighborhood. Right before he begins to get taken advantage of. The first flashback is the first truly weird moment of the film, showing the most elaborate stage ever to make cookies. While that's strange and all that, what makes it so beautiful is that this is the inventor's life's work, and it's being used to create something that's literally sweet. With something as simple as a heart-shaped cookie, his next creation is now a possibility to be explored. We get to witness the beginning of his creation from a cookie shaped like a heart. Simple and effective. The second occurs right before Edward and we as the audience are introduced to Kim, who becomes the most important person to him and the character who's telling the story. We flash back to the inventor reading to him as Edward processes information, and we briefly see the stages the inventor was taking in creating an actual man. Edward hasn't been fully constructed yet, but the mind certainly is as he ends up cracking a smile. Again, simple but effective. The third, and by far the most important, comes when Kim finally decides to embrace Edward after being told in the most adorable voice imaginable.
I can't.
I have to say that the music in this scene is perfect, euphoric even. The transition to the inventor unveiling Edward's new hands just puts me in a state of pure awe. Thematically, this next step would have changed the course of Edward's life, and the score elevates the scene even further. It goes from somber to poetic to tragic, all within the span of 2 minutes. Again, Danny Elfman's score is truly sensational throughout, and the movie just wouldn't be the same without it. In this scene, Edward loses the man who invented him, and because he doesn't have regular human hands, he can only reach out with his scissors that not only destroy the hands made for him, but scar the now deceased inventor. The last time he tried to hold somebody left a bloody trace, and that's clearly haunted him ever since. But that hugging embrace by Kim not only showed he could hug someone, but it also showed he was being embraced by someone else who truly loved him for who he was and not what he could do. And that was all Edward ever wanted, to be loved. It's amazing when you rediscover something you loved when you were younger, to not only fall in love with it all over again, but to also grasp many of the underlying themes to the story. Edward Scissorhands is most certainly a romantic fantasy at its core, and its brilliant mixture of comedy, drama, fantasy, and gothic horror, alongside one of the most memorable and inspiring scores of all time, makes it an all-time classic for a reason. And it does all of this in such a way that feels spontaneous, natural, eccentric, but beautiful. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. For next week, I will have my very special review for David Fincher's Seven. I can't wait to share that with you guys. Hope everyone has a wonderful holiday. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to this channel and turn on post notifications so you never miss a video. Thank you so much as always for watching, guys, and stay tuned.